It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle-belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Good morning, boys and girls. It's time again for a word from our book, Christmas Cookies. This scrumptious book captures the spirit of the holiday and teaches us vocabulary words such as tradition and celebrate, like baking the same kind of cookies at the same time each year. We get holiday lessons and vocabulary all in one in this book, which is a dictionary of sorts. The illustrations and the timeless morsels of wisdom are as fresh as the aroma from cookies straight out of the oven. So let's go ahead and take another bite.
Hey, good morning. I'm Amy Lumpkin. I'm the registrar here at Flint Hill. Tradition means each year at the same time we make the same cookies and wear our special matching aprons.
Flint Hill students and staff and community, just everybody, good morning. We're so happy to have you here with us at Flint Hill today. Today is Wednesday, December the 2nd, and we are just super excited to have you here with us. There's lots of things going on at Flint Hill. There's never a dull moment. The boys and girls are doing great. I've been to different classrooms, and they're working hard, and we just couldn't be prouder of you if you are virtual or if you are an in-person student. Now, let's talk about what's going on this month. This is the month of December. It's the jolliest month of the year, and there's so much going on, and there's so much busyness going on. I want to tell you what's important at Flint Hill that I want you to know about, okay? So, there is 24 more days counting today until Christmas. There are 13 days, school days, left until Polar Express Pajama Day. Bring $1 and you can wear pajamas, and we're going to give you a Polar Express golden ticket for you to be able to watch the Polar Express that day. Great fun, boys and girls. We want you to get excited about it, and we want you to participate. So if you don't have those jammies yet, get you a pair of jammies and wear them to school on December the 18th and bring that dollar, okay? On Friday, this Friday, it's sock day. We want you to wear your craziest, funnest socks, okay? We want you to wear them, bring $1, and that dollar is going to go to the Relay for Life. We're going to be taking pictures. It's just going to be great. So we hope you will enjoy that, okay? Now, I hope you have taken note that you've been hearing some Christmas carols in the hallway. There's been a little bit of joyful noise coming out of the speakers in the hallway. So next week, WPTV is going to be coming around on Monday and Tuesday. Now, I've already sent the information to your teachers so they know what day and what time we will be in the area of your building. We're going to be dashing through the halls, going in and out of the rooms, and we're going to be letting you have a sing-along, okay? So I hope your teachers have explained to you how that's going to work and that you are ready and prepared with your verse that goes with the song your grade level was assigned. We can't wait to put it all together, boys and girls. It's going to be awesome hearing us all together. You do have to wear your mask, okay? You have to sing with your mask on, so you're going to have to sing loud, okay? So get ready for that. That's going to be awesome, okay? And we're really excited about that. Also, on December the 15th, we are going to have a couple of special guests in our school. And there's going to be some information going home about that. And we're really super excited about it. I can't let the secret out of the bag yet. I'm still waiting on an approval from Dr. DiNardo, but I know she's not going to be a Grinch. She's going to let us do this, I feel sure, so long as I can get it together, okay? And I've got lots of people helping, and I'm just super excited that the people have joined in and willing to help us put this special event on that I think everyone's going to be really proud of. So I want you to keep thinking about that. Today's news show, I can't say enough. It's just awesome. We want to thank Ms. Rebolt. She's going to be bringing us our story today. Today is a special education day, and she's going to be bringing it. And I thought that she did an awesome job on that. We've got a couple of little sneaks and peeks within our news show. We hope you enjoy. And please, boys and girls, pay attention. If you need to go back and watch this again later, you can always do that. To the words, the cookie lesson words for each day, please make sure that you pay attention to those words, because I think you're going to learn something, and that's what it's all about. So until tomorrow, have a great day, and I will see you back here on Thursday for another great day of learning at Flint Hill.
I trust you guys didn't freeze this morning getting to school with the chilly temperatures that we had. Hopefully you bundled up and you are ready. Today's high is going to be 54 degrees, and tonight's low is another chilly temperature of 27 degrees. There'll be lots of sunshine today, boys and girls, but you still need to keep those jackets handy. Hope you guys enjoy your afternoon, and see you here in the morning.
Hi, Wolfpack family. Ms. Rebholz here to bring you our story for today. Today is Special Education Awareness Day. What is special education, you may be wondering? Special education is a part of the school system. Its purpose is to help students who have special needs learn in a way that works for them. Special needs are a part of a way a person can think, move, or behave. There is nothing wrong with having special needs. These needs just make an individual unique. When I was going into college to become a teacher, I knew the kind of teacher I wanted to be. I wanted to be a special education teacher. I knew that I wanted to work with students who had special needs because I wanted to help them find what helps them achieve in education, just like students who do not have special needs. I also wanted to do what I'm doing right now. I wanted to be able to teach my students with special needs and students without special needs that they are all awesome. Having special needs does not make someone less. It does not make them a bad friend. Having special needs makes a person that much more awesome. Special needs allows for a person to see the world differently, to see happiness where others would not, and have strengths where others can be overlooked. Being a special education teacher is one of my favorite things I've ever done. I love coming to work every day knowing that I will get to make a difference in a child's life. I hope that through this story, I may have made some in yours. Be a friend to someone who is different than you. If a student in your class does something that may seem unusual to you, don't laugh or make fun of them, because they may have just discovered something interesting that no one else has discovered yet. Having special needs is different, but it's not bad. As you see me and other teachers in the halls or on Zooms with a smile, know that we love what we do. Teaching students, some who may have special needs and some who don't. You're all amazing to us.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic from which it stands,
one nation,
under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Wolfpack, this is Sean Long, and get ready for Polar Express Day. Polar Express Day is on December 18th. Also, make sure to wear your PJs and bring $1 that will go to Relay for Life.